The handstand traction tower is designed to be used in conjunction with either an arm board or hand table. Prior to positioning the patient, all pads must be removed from the arm board or hand table. To begin assembly, remove the sterilization tray from the handstand container and place it onto a sturdy surface. The tray contains the handstand components. Assemble the tower using the quick connect etchings on each of the components. First, lock the lower tower into the base plate by inserting the key on the bottom of the lower tower into the key slot on the base plate. Rotate until the lower tower sliding pin locks in place. Next, connect the upper tower and rotation joint into the lower tower with the tower locking knob. Depress the silver button on the top of the upper tower and rotation joint and insert the lower arm into the rotation joint opening. Release the button and ensure that the lower arm is locked in the vertical position. Then depress the black lever on the lower arm and insert the upper arm. The height of the upper arm can be adjusted depending on patient arm length. Hook the scale rack onto the threaded rod in the upper arm. The tower is now assembled and ready for patient positioning. To position the patient's arm for surgery, flex the arm 90 degrees and rest the elbow on the base plate against the upper tower. If a tourniquet is to be used, it should be in place at this point. Ensure that both the healthcare provider and the patient are free of pinch points during setup. To secure the patient's upper arm to the handstand tower, place the buckles of the bicep strap in the channels on the base plate until they're next to either side of the patient's arm. Adjust the strap length until the patient's arm is secured to the base plate. Then, ensure that the foam on the bicep strap is centered over the patient's arm. Next, place the patient's forearm against the recess in the upper tower. The height of the upper tower can be adjusted depending on the patient's forearm length. Insert the forearm strap buckle bracelet into the upper tower and wrap the forearm strap around the patient's forearm. Lock the buckle into the bracket. Adjust the strap length until the patient's forearm is secured to the upper tower. Place the digit traps on the appropriate fingers to obtain the desired traction. Digit traps should extend beyond the proximal interphalangeal joints to prevent slippage. Adjust the cable tie on each digit trap to lock at the base of the patient's finger. The cable tie is always able to be released and tensioned. Then, place the ball chains on the digit traps into the recesses of the scale rack to attach the digit traps to the handstand. Ensure the ball chains securely rest in the scale rack detent. Traction can now be adjusted to achieve desired distraction. Micro-adjustment can be made by adjusting the knob on the upper arm. A reference to the amount of traction will be displayed on the scale in 5-pound increments up to 20 pounds. Once traction is applied, ensure the patient's fingers remain secured in each digit trap before making any incisions. The wrist may be positioned to allow for wrist flexion, extension, or ulnar or volar deviation by depressing the button on the rotation joint and adjusting the upper and lower arm to the adequate position. Additionally, the upper and lower arm may be rotated about the vertical axis of the rotation joint to allow for access of instruments into the wrist or to necessitate C-arm imaging. To disassemble the tower, first remove the scale rack from the threaded rod in the upper arm. Follow the etchings on the sterilization tray, which guide each part back into its properly marked space. Next, depress the black lever on the lower arm and remove the upper arm. Then, depress the silver button on top of the upper tower to remove the lower arm. Remove the tower locking knob, which releases the upper tower from the lower tower. Finally, pull on the silver locking pin on the side of the lower tower and twist to release it from the base plate. Please refer to the instructions for use for more information.